Om Shanti, 21st December 2022. English Murli. Essence. Sweet children, you are benefactors for all human beings. You have to benefit many. You must practice becoming bodiless, and you must also definitely do service. Question: in which one aspect does even the father say that it is destined in the drama? And he then becomes silent. Answer: when children who have taken sustenance from the father for a long time then become influenced by Maya, get married and go away somewhere, when they become amazed and then run away, the father says it is destined in the drama and becomes silent. The father knows that these are obstacles in the yajna. The father is concerned that the children don't become trapped in anyone's name or form. Maya creates many obstacles. This is why Baba advises you, children, you mustn't be afraid of Maya. Become victorious by having remembrance of the father. Om Shanti. You sweetest children know that you are sitting in front of Bap and Dada. Everything is new. According to Srimad, you have to remember the one father alone. The father gives you Srimad through the body of Dada. You children are repeatedly cautioned, Man Mana Bhava, that is, remember the father. You mustn't remember this Dada. The Dada's soul remembers the father, therefore you too have to remember him. You souls are bodiless and I too am bodiless. It is just that I am teaching you through this body. He is not the almighty authority. Only the one father is the almighty authority. Although you become the masters of the world, you cannot be called almighty authorities. You conquer Ravan through the almighty authority and claim your royal status once again. The father's order is, remember me, your father. You have now understood the secrets of the beginning, the middle and the end of the tree. You have now become so sensible, that is, you have the knowledge in your intellects. You receive a very high status through this knowledge. You become Narayan from an ordinary human. This is the study of Raj Yoga. You also studied this study in the previous cycle. Your aim and objective in front of you, and it then depends on how much effort each one of you makes. You have to make a lot of effort, and it is very easy. It is not difficult to know your own home. We souls are bodiless and we reside in the land of peace. You would not say peace of mind there. In fact, it is wrong to use the words peace of mind. The mind is a horse. While a soul has a body, the mind cannot become peaceful. Actions have to be performed. Temporary peace is experienced at night when sleeping. A soul becomes tired from doing everything with his physical organs and so he becomes bodiless. The soul says, I am feeling sleepy. I am tired. So the soul then becomes bodiless. You now have to remember the father so that your sins are absolved. Your sins will not be absolved by going to sleep. You have to make effort to remember the Father for this. This effort is very essential. The Father repeatedly says, remember me. The more service you do, the more of your own subjects you will create. Many subjects have to be created. You have to become benefactors for many people. You are benefactors for all human beings. In Ravan's kingdom, no one benefits anyone. When human beings make donations and perform charity, they believe that they are performing good actions. You say that the gates to paradise will open through this war. This is a very good war. You Brahmins have now become knowledgeable souls. How can those who have the five vices in them become deities? In order to change from an ordinary human into Narayan, you need to make very good effort. You have to make unlimited effort. No one apart from the Father can enable you to attain such a high status. No one else can teach you Raj Yoga. You now also know the biography of Lakshmi and Narayan. How did they claim their kingdom? From where did they receive it? Whom did they conquer? You explain to everyone that you are now studying Raj Yoga and becoming like Lakshmi and Narayan. God Himself is teaching you the story of changing from an ordinary man into Narayan. So you children should have a lot of intoxication. The Father has explained that it is the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, who establishes this Brahmin religion. Where would the Brahmin religion exist? Would it exist in the Golden Age? No. It would definitely exist here. Prajapita also exists here. The Father established the Brahmin religion and created the mouth-born creation of Brahma. He himself says, I enter the body of an ordinary human being at the end of his many births. He doesn't know his own births. People ask, why have you kept Brahma here? Oh, but Prajapita has to exist here. They wonder how Brahma, a deity of the subtle region, could exist here. The Father sits here and explains to you the secrets of the 84 births of Prajapita Brahma. This is his final birth. God has to enter this one. The one that exists at the beginning will also exist at the end. Only the Father explains all of these secrets. Shri Baba has had these pictures created through divine visions. Baba gave the direction that you have to prove that the cycle is 5,000 years. Baba has had the picture of heaven and hell made. It is not written in the Gita that the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, taught you. Look. It takes so long to explain. You continue to receive explanations day by day. Whatever was explained to you in the previous cycle is being explained to you now at this time. The part that is recorded in me, this soul, then repeats. You understand that this is an impure world. It is now the last birth of everyone. The drama is now coming to an end. How could the deity religion be established in the Golden Age? In the Golden Age, there is just the one undivided deity religion. At this time, it is your Brahmin religion. The secrets of the variety form image are also explained to you. Brahmins means the top knot, and then Brahmins become deities. People don't know that Shri Baba creates the Brahmin religion. You are now being transferred, in brackets converted from Shudras into Brahmins. From down below, you go up above the sky. Souls now have to return home. When people go to the temples of the goddesses, they don't know who Jagadamba is. She is goddess of knowledge and she then becomes the princess. Goddesses are worshipped a great deal. Lakshmi and Narayan are in the Golden Age and Rama and Sita are in the Silver Age. All the rest are images of this time. There are innumerable pictures. They have built innumerable temples. You know that Brahma and Saraswati are Brahmins. Lakshmi would not be called a Brahmin. She is a deity. When she is a Brahmin, she fulfills all desires for 21 births. When she becomes Lakshmi, her grade is reduced. You are now the children of God. Your grades are high. No human beings can understand these things. You are the decoration of the Brahmin clan and you now belong to God. You will then go into the deity clan. This confluence age is benevolent. The Father makes Bharat into heaven. Bharat was ancient heaven. However, this doesn't sit in anyone's intellect. If the people of Bharat were to know this, they would become happy that they were the masters of heaven. When a person dies, people say that he has gone to heaven. Only heavenly God the Father creates heaven. The incorporeal world exists anyway. You cannot use the word establishment for that. It is a religion that is established. That is the home of souls which becomes empty at this time. All souls will then go back number-wise. This has to be made to sit in the intellects of children in order for them to explain to others. All the souls who come to establish a religion have to go through the stages of Sato, Rajo and Tamo. You now have to go up above. It is now your stage of ascent. You are spiritual Brahmins, the mouth-born creation. Those people are physical Brahmins who are a physical creation. They take you on physical pilgrimages and relate religious stories. You Brahmins are those who explain the secrets of the beginning, the middle and the end of the world. Physical Brahmins also come here. When they become aware that you are the true Brahmins, they understand that they have been relating false stories. They have false scriptures under their arms and you have knowledge in your intellects. Everything they relate is from studying the scriptures, whereas you have knowledge in your intellects. Just as Baba has it in his intellect, Baba is the truth and living being, the blissful one and the seed. He is incorporeal. Your intellects have to imbibe this knowledge. Knowledge is not difficult. You simply have to pay attention. It isn't that you have to leave your homes and families. That is just an excuse. For instance, when a daughter doesn't want to get married, her father beats her. However, because she is young, she cannot run away anywhere. When she becomes an adolescent, she comes and takes refuge. It is sung, "I came and took refuge with you." This is because they are very unhappy in Ravan's kingdom. They then claim their inheritance from the father. For instance, when someone is beaten a lot by her husband, she would feel it is better to take refuge with Baba. However, to leave your home and family is not like going to your auntie's home. It takes effort. Although sannyasis renounce everything, they don't forget their friends and relatives. Some even go back home. It requires effort. They are not able to have yoga with the Brahm element that quickly. Here you know that this is an old world and that the relationships are also old. You have to renounce everything including your bodies. That is why you have disinterest in this old world. You even have disinterest in your old bodies. This is unlimited disinterest, whereas theirs is limited, Rajoguni disinterest. This is unlimited Satopradhan disinterest. We don't leave the world. You are making effort to go from the old world to the new world. Those people don't believe that they will go to the new world and experience happiness. This happiness is for you. Their renunciation is Rajopradhan, whereas your renunciation is Satopradhan. You children have to become Satopradhan. Alloy will be burnt away by your having yoga. Therefore, this is called the fire of yoga. It doesn't seem right to say the fire of remembrance. Fire of yoga in which sins are burnt away is said It is a very easy matter, but children repeatedly say, "Baba, I forget." The father says, "Children become soul conscious. You remain soul conscious from the golden age to the silver age. For half a cycle, you were soul conscious, and then for half a cycle, you became body conscious. Therefore, you now find that it requires effort to become soul conscious. In the golden age, you understand that you shed your body and take another. There is the example of the snake. That example is for you. Sannyasis want to merge into the element of light, but they don't know that they have to come and take another costume again. You know that you will shed your old bodies and then take new ones. You have the desire to shed your old clothes. The example of the tortoise is also for you. While performing actions, continue to remember the Father. The Father himself is the bestower of salvation. The bestower of salvation is only one Shri Baba and none other. All of you souls are the children of Shri Baba and also the children of Prajapita Brahma. First of all, there are Brahmins. Then the tree continues to grow. This is the tree of the variety of religions. First of all, there is the deity religion. Then those of Islam come. And then the Buddhist, etc. come. Branches and twigs continue to emerge. When new branches emerge, they are praised. Then their strength continues to decrease. You are those who have a lot of strength and become the masters of the world. There are no ministers, etc. there. It is the rule of kings. Advisors come in the copper age. There are no kings or queens now. This too is in the predestined drama. Bharat was heaven and it is now hell. Hell is also Satopradhan at first, and then hell, which has now become Tamopradhan, is called the extreme depths of hell. The father says, "I have to make so much effort. I have so much concern to see that some children don't fall into the hands of bandits. The world is very dirty. Many dirty, impure people come to the centers. They become trapped in name and form. There are many types of obstacles created in the yajna. Maya also causes obstacles. Then they choke a great deal. Nevertheless, you have to remember the Father. You have to stand on the battlefield and fight. You mustn't be afraid. Many children divorce the Father. Some children took sustenance from the Father for so many years, and then they got married and went away somewhere. There are those who were amazed and who then ran away. This is then said to be destined in the drama, and then Baba becomes silent. The children who remain busy in doing service experience a lot of happiness." Acha. To the sweetest beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children extend their love, remembrance, say good morning, namaste, and thank you to the spiritual Bap Dada. Essence for Dharana. First point. In order to take refuge with the father, make your intellects have unlimited renunciation. Forget the old world and bodies and make effort to remain soul conscious. Number two, maintain the intoxication that you Brahmins are those who fulfill the desires of everyone. Blessing. May you be a constant server and serve with your elevated drishti, attitude and actions. Explanation. Just as your body cannot stay without breathing, in the same way, the breath of Brahmin life is doing service. Just as when you cannot breathe, you become unconscious. In the same way, If a Brahmin soul is not busy in doing service, he would become unconscious. Therefore, continue to serve at every moment with your elevated drishti, attitude and actions. If you don't have a chance to serve with words, then serve with your mind. When you do all types of service, you will be able to claim full marks. Slogan: The throne of the stage of a detached observer is the throne of making accurate decisions. Om Shanti.